While creating a website, it is important to identify which type you need and want, static or dynamic website. And the key difference between these two types is a website scripting that dynamic websites have. Static websites are written in HTML code, and the content on the page will be constant. It means that it cannot be changed without the developer editing the source code, and it's one of the biggest disadvantages of static websites. Whereas dynamic websites use server-side or client-side languages and can change the content dynamically while the page is running on the browser. For example, a content management system gives the owner of the website an opportunity to easily change the content without any help of a developer. This is a static website. It looks like a printed page. It contains fixed number of pages and the content here stays fixed all the time. And Facebook, for example, is a dynamic website in which both server-side and client-side are regularly updated. It can create web pages and generate content dynamically. But are there any benefits of static websites? Well, first of all, it takes less time to load, because it has only some markup content, and page speed is an important factor in terms of performance. Dynamic websites need some time to process the request on the server and render information to the user. Another thing is security. In case of a static website, a user cannot change the server data. Communication is possible only one way, from server to client. That's why they are highly secure. And of course, it's easy to develop a static website, as it requires less technical knowledge. It can be developed much cheaper and faster, but it will lack rich functionality and intuitiveness of dynamic websites. All approaches can be fine. It depends on what you are building. If there is no need in database, content management system, and dynamic content update, then static website with their speed, simplicity, security, and code will be more beneficial for the owner and the user. Otherwise, dynamic websites will be a better choice. Please write in comments why you've decided to become a web developer and what topics you are interested in. And if you want to be the first to watch such free educational videos, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Have a good week and see you next Tuesday.